in this hour that it's now time for revival for America. It's now time for revival to come to the church. Hallelujah. When God shows up, something changes. When God shows up, the atmosphere changes. When God separated the Red Sea, even in the midst of distress, the Bible says, if your name is written in the book of life, there is the promise of deliverance. This is the hour, church. He said, be not troubled what you see on the television. Be not troubled what you see in the newspapers. But know, the end is not yet. Be not troubled. The Bible is coming to the church. When God shows up, something changes. The atmosphere changes. When God visited this place in Azusa Street in the early 1900s, something changed. God visited this place. People would get out of the chain of coming all the way to this place and only to go out in the Spirit. People would walk past that building and they would come under the power of God, because God showed up. We need God to show up. We need God to show up, not only in our churches, but in your families. You need God to show up in your marriage. You need God to show up in your children. You need God to show up in this nation right now. Amen. This is the hour. The Lord said, get on a plane and come to America, and you will come on the day just after the election. That day was the 11th of the 9th. So people did not want to get on a plane. The plane was empty because it had something to do with 9/11. Because the fear in people's hearts. See, the fear will grip people in this hour because we are living in a time of distress. But he said, be not troubled. The end is not yet. You don't have to be troubled by what is happening to your neighbors, what is happening around us. Because when we have our eyes on Jesus Christ, our hope is that he will come and show up. Do you want him to show up in your lives? This is the hour. And he says, in a time of latter rain, ask for that rain. If revival is happening in the nations, it can happen here. But your hunger will determine your visitation. He has promised in Isaiah 43 verse 3. He says he will pour water onto the thirsty. He will flood the dry areas of your life. Are you thirsty for God? Are you hungry for God? Are you willing to wait until he shows up? We need God to show up. The Bible says, when God does not build the house, the laborer builds in vain. We need the Holy Spirit once again. We need God to come and touch America once again, to bring it back to the great nation that it was. A president will not change anything, but when God changes and shows up, something changes. We need God in this hour. In everything you do, God is here. So this is just an introductory. Hallelujah. But God is going to show up. But your hunger will always determine that visitation. God is going to show up. And I encourage you in this now. Keep your eyes focused on him. Don't look at what's happening in the media. Don't look at what other people are saying. Just keep your eyes on him and say, God, I need.
Is our heart pure? Don't worry about anybody else.
first